What a sinister vocalization, right? That's a kiwi, one of the most bizarre birds out there that few people know about. And that vocalization in the video, is it real? Look, this kiwi video has been circulating the internet in recent weeks, and a bunch of people have been asking me, what kind of crazy bird is that? And is the vocalization in the video real? Well, no beating around the bush. The bird's vocalization in the video is indeed real. This video was recorded in the backyard of a resident of Stewart Island, New Zealand, where the kiwi lives. And when I say kiwis are strange birds, they really are very strange. They are primarily nocturnal birds that don't fly, endemic to New Zealand, practically have no wings, just a tiny vestigial wing. They also have no tail. Their eggs are huge compared to their body size. They don't see very well. They have a sensory beak, and their feathers are so fine and different that they even look like mammal fur. The truth is, they're a bird that looks the least like a bird. Kiwis belong to the Pterygidae family, closely related to cassowaries, ostriches, and other flightless birds. There are 5 species of kiwis, all very similar to each other and all exclusive to the forests of New Zealand. And they're quite big birds, over 23.6 inch in length, weighing just over 6.61 pounds, roughly the size of a domestic chicken. And the bird in the viral video is likely the southern brown kiwi, which is the species found on the island where the footage was taken. I'd even say it's a female, as females have a rougher, more growling, and scarier vocalization, by the way. Meanwhile, the male of this species has a high-pitched vocalization, which reminds me of the sound of a seagull. Unlike most birds in the world, kiwis have a very different, quite poor vision, okay? The eye is quite small in proportion to the body, and vision isn't as essential for the species as it is for other birds. In fact, researchers have found several blind or partially blind kiwis living peacefully in nature. These birds have a highly developed sense of smell, which is unusual for birds. Because their nostrils are at the tip of their beak, which is also very strange, kiwis can locate insects and other invertebrates on the ground using only their sense of smell and touch, which is a crucial adaptation for a nocturnal bird with reasonable vision. Besides invertebrates, kiwis also feed on fruits, amphibians, and other small vertebrates. You know, I find it fascinating to see these kiwis walking on the ground, isn't it? And just for curiosity, there's a hypothesis that the mainly nocturnal habits of these birds might be a result of the introduction of predators on the islands, including humans. This is because in places where predators live and where exotic predators have been removed from the islands, kiwis are often seen walking during the day, being active during the day. By the way, the presence of introduced mammals, such as dogs, cats, and ferrets, remains the main threats to this peculiar and friendly bird. Oh, and you know the drill, right? If you're enjoying this video, give it a like, it won't cost you anything, and it really helps boost engagement on this channel. Look, if you ever get the chance to see a kiwi in the wild or even in a zoo, you'll notice it has no wings or tail. The wings in this species are vestigial, meaning they serve no function for the bird, and are so tiny they're practically invisible under the feathers. And speaking of feathers, the feathers of this species are also quite unique. They look more like mammal fur than actual feathers. That's because the feathers have simpler structures, adapted for terrestrial life, serving as insulation and camouflage. It's also interesting that around their beak, there are some modified feathers with a tactile function, which are quite long and even resemble a cat's whiskers. Almost everything about this group of birds is different, right? And their reproductive behavior also stands out. They're monogamous birds that maintain long-lasting bonds. A pair can stay together for years or even decades. To reproduce, they dig burrows on steep banks, where the female lays a single egg, rarely two. And the kiwi egg, folks, look, it's massive compared to the bird's size. Like, it can weigh over 20% of the female's weight. And even though the kiwi is roughly the size of a domestic chicken, the egg is about 6 times larger than a chicken egg. It's no wonder kiwis hold the record for the largest eggs relative to bird size. The egg pretty much takes up a large part of the bird's body. Of course, producing such a large egg consumes a lot of energy. The female ends up eating more than 3 times the normal amount of food. Regarding parental care, in 4 out of the 5 species, it's the male that incubates the egg for 2 to 3 months. And as soon as the chick hatches, the male takes care of it alone. But the chick is already capable of feeding itself. And these birds have a relatively long lifespan. They can live from 25 to 40 years in the wild. And why is this bird called a kiwi, like the fruit? Curious, right? But the truth is, the name has nothing to do with the kiwi fruit. The word actually comes from an indigenous language of New Zealand, referring to the sound the bird makes. It's an onomatopoeic type of sound. However, some linguists question the origin of this name, saying the kiwi name actually comes from a Polynesian word, attributed to some shorebirds. Due to misidentification, the kiwi began to be called kiwi as well. Regardless of its origin, the fact is that kiwi is now a well-established name for the 5 species of the Apterygidae family. And birds hold a special significance for New Zealand. They're recognized as a symbol of the country, appearing on coats of arms, emblems of many cities, clubs, and institutions in New Zealand. Come on, admit it, right? This kiwi video vocalizing is sensational, isn't it? I know it's a bizarre vocalization, but I think it's awesome. Now tell me, were you familiar with the kiwi before? Oh folks, just to improve the engagement of this video and the recommendations of the channel's videos on your YouTube homepage, do me a favor, leave at least 1 kiwi bird in the comments, okay? So that's it, folks. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.